sure you enjoy seeing us here rather than in the stockyards.
But if you have to smoke, please go into the lobby because the fire marshal will not allow the air back into the building if there's excess of smoking. Last night's audience cooperated, and since this is one of the few perfectly acoustic halls left in the country that accepts rock, let's see that we can come back next year. And once again, your six closest relatives and my name.
Thank you. Napoleon Rubik Rock and Jimmy Sachs and Lee Fogel. Norma Bell on alto sax. Andre Lewis on keyboards. Little skinny Terry Tinkerbox Posey on drums. Roy, Ralph, Mole now completely connectorized. We hope he stays away throughout the whole concert tonight. Estrada on bass. And the greatest ushers in the world out there among you with their flashlights ready to dance for us a little bit later in the show.
On the water, where the shot bubbles fall, in the morning, by your radio, do the walls close in, the summer hate ya. You ain't got no friends, and all the others that hate ya, cause the life you've been leading, gotta go. Let me straighten you out. I know. Now get your shoes and socks on, people, because it's right around the corner by the Fillmore Towers. Out through the night, and so scary and green, it's the same place where I can imagine having a blizzard. Out through the night, and so scary and green, it's the same place where they can imagine having a wretched disease, bromidrosis, and well, they should. But us regular folks who might wear a tennis shoe or an occasional python boot know this exquisite little inconvenience by the name of state bug. How true that is, you know. My python boot was too tight. Couldn't get it off last night. A week went by, and now it's July. I finally got that sucker off, and my girlfriend cried. He got stink bug. Yo, stink bug, darling. You're a stinking foot. Foot's the hurts. Oh, I know. Stink foot, stink foot. Hi, hi. Did you wrench it off, you suppose? Well, here, Fido, here, Fido. The slippery's little puppy. Yes, that's a good dog. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Fido, the dog that was supposed to bring my slippers to me. Fido! Fido, my friend.
Yes, Fido.
Fido, I asked you in a very nice way to please bring the slippers, little puppy. You know what that means, don't you? You do speak English, don't you? Answer me, Fido.
Well, Frank, I was so far out, and I was so laid back, and I was tripping, and I was stoned, and I was grooving behind it, and...
Fido, you understand that when a person larger than yourself instructs you to bring things that go on his feet, and you, being a mere dog, do not comply with the larger person's wishes, this opens you up to many different forms of abuse popular here in Chicago.
Yes, Frank, I understand.
Well, first of all, your punishment will consist of not being able to go to Russia for 2 weeks.
Oh, no, no.
And then, after that, you're going to be, well, how can I put this discreetly? I am going to stomp the living doo-doo out of you right here on stage. What do you think about that, buddy?
Oh, hurt me, hurt me, hurt me.
Thank you.
the beginning, God made the light. The light. God made the light. Very good. Very, very good. Now, later on, after he made the light, he figured that he had done a real fine job with that. He made the poodle. The poodle, in its original God-given state, was a normal-looking dog with hair all over its wretched little dog-type body. After God had made the light and the poodle, he made two big mistakes. The first one was called the man, and the second one was called Woo-Man. Now, after he had created the Woo-Man, the Woo-Man looked at the poodle and got a real good idea. Whereupon she addressed the man and induced this wretched chump to go out and get a job. The man went out and got a job and made enough money so that the Woo-Man could actually force the man to buy her a pair of poodle clipping scissors. Dun dun dun. Whereupon she taketh the poodle clipping scissors and proceeded to convert the already, well, you know how dogs are. She converted this normal looking poodle into one of the ugliest fucking things that anybody has ever seen in their complete entire lifetime. Now here's what she did, and she did believe that she was doing something artistic. Wait a minute. She took the poodle clipping scissors and removed part of the hair from this area around the muzzle, or snout, as it is known in the poodle clipping trade, and sort of worked it over so the front part of the dog-type snout was a little bit fuzzy here, just sort of like a French tickler of the canine world, if you know what I'm talking about. And then proceeded to remove a large quantity of hair from the abdominal zone of the aforementioned poodle. And she left a little mothball on the end of the poodle's tail and left a few long hairs here to collect those brown, delightful objects that poodles have become so famous for. And then, on the feet of the aforementioned God-given poodle, she allowed to continue to grow many hairs, causing the feet of the poodle to become extremely attractive to her taste, you know? And then she left a little on the ear, a little on this ear here, and she looked at the poodle and she says, "This is a very sexual fucking dog." Then she turned to the man, who had rightfully earned the title of chump of the universe, and said, "Honey, it's time to go to work." And the man left the cave and went out to raise a little bit more money for the next set of poodle clipping shears. And the woman stuck her legs up in the air like this. Oh, and in a casual sort of a voice, looked deep into the poodle's eyes and said, "Here, Fido, here." Whereupon the little dog walked over to the Woo-Man and stuffed its ticklish little snout right between her legs, stuck out its little tongue, and prepared to chew the vital life giving fluids from the certain special Woo-Man. And that's what our song is about, ladies and gentlemen.
No reservation, no
tell, tonight is going to be such a jolly night here at the Auditorium Theater. But we're going to take you back in time. Let your mind go back to that golden era of Ruben and the Jets, to the song which unfortunately doesn't have a clue in it. We wish it did. Thinking this song is, how can I be such a fool?
Thank you. They took Andre's watch like she always do.
Well, that's alright too.
Thank you.
is out of sight. He has Irish leather.
Over the Simmons bar on a Tuesday night, the moon was dim, the man was high. They did the work together.
Insert the thermometer, read the temperature, give it a whiff, put it aside,
dash into the other room, fill up the bag, dash back in, stuff the nozzle into the waiting orifice, and glug, glug, gluggity, glug, pump her right up with some tepid water. And then he beat his meat, pull it out, tell her not to call the cops for 5 minutes, and disappear. And this is our song about it.
Thank you. seem strange to her than thee. Carolina, hardcore, ecstasy.
Don't care. You're a lonely little girl. Yeah. a plague upon your ignorance and the greatest fear of your lovely life. Where did Bobby go when he went to town? Who are all those groups that he brings around? All your children are poor, unfortunate victims of lies you believe. A plague upon your ignorance that keeps them down from the truth they deserve.
Thank you.
Napoleon Murphy Brown on tenor sax and lead vocals. Norman Bell on alto saxophone. Andre Lewis on keyboards. Bill Skinny Tank and Bojo on drums. Brian Strider on bass.